the snowmelt beads. This is calcium chloride. It's not rock salt, but calcium chloride. These beads are the kind of beads that are used here at the school to throw on the ice and snow in front of the school during the wintertime. They make a solution that is heavier or denser than water, and the way we make it is by simply dissolving these beads in water, you can tip it that way, until no more will dissolve. So we put them in there and we fill it up till no more will dissolve. Now this takes a day to do this, and at the end of the day, let me get rid of that. Shot. This takes a day to do this. At the end of the day, we're ready to use the solution. The solution can be reused over and over again. Now, Zach's going to pour the solution without pouring the beads into our empty bucket here. Go ahead. Don't you put your finger in the way, Zach. Don't put your finger in the way. There you go. No, all of it.
All right.
Just don't pour the beads in.
I know
how to do that. All right, there you go. All right. No, more of it, all of it. Yeah, just be careful not to pour the beads in, that's all. That's enough. No, you don't want to get any beads in there.
Okay.
All right, that's good. Now you show them that you've left the beads in the bottom.
Mm-hmm.
All right. All right. Now, Glenn's going to add the untreated material that came off the small screen. Now just, Glenn, add about a third of it, because we may have to do it one more time. Carefully.
It's not getting wet.
Yeah. Try not to get him too wet. All right, that's good. That's enough. Now, you'll notice, now tip it for him, Zach. You'll notice that the wood has floated to the top and the rocks have settled to the bottom. Now he pours it through the screen. Try to keep your thumb out of the way. There you go. Don't want to get covered with. Pours it through the screen back into the original bucket. Go ahead, just turn it horizontal, Zach. That's it. All right. No, you don't want the rocks to go in. See, you're going to watch it so the rocks don't go in. But,
yeah.
All right. Now, and you can show them the bucket again. Now, what's happened here is that the rocks have settled and the fossils have settled to the bottom where the unwanted wood has been separated off the top. Why don't you give them the white bucket down this end? Down this end. Down here. And then Zach dumps the, here, go ahead. And you dump that in there. He dumps through this guard there. The, yeah. No, get it all out. Get it, all of it, there we go. Okay, good. Now, Zach has done that, and we're going to rinse. We'll rinse this off and dry it, and this will be the material that we'll sort. So, okay. Hi. I'm Dr. Peter Krantz, and this week we're in the classroom at School Without Walls. I have with me today students from Montessori program at Watkins Elementary School. And what we're going to do this week is we're going to sort the material that we washed last week out of the clay. And it's been drying all week, and now we have it. John, would you bring the bucket of the material from the coarse screen, please, the half-inch screen? Okay. John's bringing me the bucket of the material from the half-inch screen, and John and Tony and Glenn and Mrs. Henderson are all going to give us a hand. John and Tony and Glenn are from the School Without Walls, and they've been in the paleontology class, and we're going to help the students here at from Watkins Elementary School learn how to sort the coarse material. Now, John, you want to pour some of that carefully, gently, down that end of the table for those students down there. That's good. And then pass it along to me. What I'm going to do is I'm going to show you. Remember from last week, there are some black pieces that look like this. That's the wood, remember that? And there are some reddish looking pieces that look like this, which is the iron ore. And remember, we saw that stuff out when we were out on our field trip. This is the wood and the iron ore, which we also saw last week. Now, there are also some other things in here which may not be wood or iron ore. So if you find something that isn't a piece of wood or isn't a piece of iron ore, I want you to put that in a third pile. So we're going to have one pile where we're going to put pieces of wood, one pile where we're going to put pieces of iron ore, and one pile where we're going to put anything that we think might be something other than pieces of iron ore. And this is how we're going to go about finding the fossils that are in the clay. Now, so you can see that we have plant-eating dinosaurs and armored dinosaurs and meat-eating dinosaurs that we find here. In fact, we find about six different kinds of dinosaurs at this site. When a student finds something that's important, like a dinosaur tooth or some identifiable bone, we put a label on it and place it in a plastic bag so the student can get credit at the museum for being the discoverer. Here I have a couple of bags with a dinosaur tooth and a dinosaur toenail in it that are going to the museum, and the students' names are placed on the labels so that the museum knows who was the discoverer. You have quite a large